Roxanne.
Benny.
What dish are you making for this challenge?
So, yeah, I'm going to be making salted caramel and macadamia praline and ganache tart, but all in one.
Well, that's brave. In 60 minutes. Good luck.
Thank you so much.
All right.
I stuck true to myself. I love baking and doing desserts. I just decided to stick to what I know, you know, really well.
Okay. Refuel it.
Hi, Chef.
What do we got?
We have egg snow with coffee and vanilla infused custard.
Sounds delightful. Great idea.
Thank you, Chef.
I am making a coconut and lime cheesecake, and I'm making my own base because I didn't have any biscuits. I hope that my invention and my ideas can come through to the judges and they can see that regardless of what ingredients, I can improvise and make what I need to make.
I'm going to do a stuffed chicken breast wrapped in its own skin.
I'm the kind of cook where I make hearty, homey kind of meals. I throw things in a pot and I let them kind of stew over hours and hours.
I'm a bit frantic because I'm running out of time at the moment, so I'm really hoping to get something on the plate before the clock runs out.
I'm making stuffed chicken breast with spinach, pepper juice and some feta wrapped in parma ham.
Maybe somebody out there will recognize me, that I may not be a professional chef, but a great cook.
So Ben, how's it looking in your section?
I've got a ganache and mixed nuts tart being made by Roxanne. And I've also got Gillian. She's also making a cheesecake.
Philippa is doing ravioli. She's steamed some bone marrow. She's going to do a little roasted with gremolata. That sounds very interesting.
There's quite a lot of meat dishes going on. The miso is doing an open ostrich sandwich. Okay. There's quite a lot of stuff going on this station.
Sim's doing a robust sort of like ribeye dish with bacon. You know, all in all, it's really hearty meat dishes. So it seems like they're sticking to what they know.
Contestants! We are halfway through this challenge. You have 30 minutes left, but you need to stop for a second.
The pantry is now closed. And what's more, we're throwing you a curveball.
Benny, bring it in.
Benny pulls in with a forklift and a big wooden box.
Hey, nice ride, Ben.
Please know what is happening.
Under this cloth, in this huge box, is a mystery ingredient. It's very versatile. You have all used it thousands of times before. But you have to include it in the dish that you are currently cooking.
Everybody, I think, kind of panics. I kind of just stop and go, please don't tell me it's something to do with chocolate.
Benny!
The tomato in all shapes and forms.
Surprise!
Now I find the tomatoes.
The tomato doesn't necessarily have to be the hero in your dish, but it has to harmoniously integrate with all the flavors that you've already created.
Now I'm making a dessert, so I thought tomatoes?
Let's go! Get your tomatoes!
There is no space in my repertoire for tomatoes, and there's half an hour left to go.
I suddenly think to myself, God, what am I doing here?
Guys, just think about this, tomatoes. They need to sit nicely in this plate.
Chickpea rosa tomatoes are quite sweet. Thought it would go well with my raspberry sauce. Come back, and my raspberry sauce has now turned into a jam.
It's gone from a raspberry sauce to a creamy raspberry and tomato sauce.
Tomatoes are going into my Provençal sauce now.
Tomatoes with a chocolate tart, I like. I really need to try and improvise now.
The tomatoes actually kind of worked out in my favor a little bit. I was looking for a color element and unfortunately I didn't recognize that they weren't in the pantry earlier.
I was looking fantastic and then I saw that I had no egg to put in my ravioli.
I'm feeling a little frazzled.
You're feeling a bit frazzled?
Yes.
Why is that?
Because I didn't take enough eggs out of the fridge, and I don't know that marrow and ricotta go.
What is the egg gonna do?
protein.
What have you replaced it with? Protein creaminess. So
okay.
You're on track.
Okay, have faith.
I'm looking at a whole lot of people that have been doing savory dishes, which for them, it was going to always be easy for them to incorporate the tomato. But the challenge was with the people that have decided to do desserts.
The nice thing about those little Rosa tomatoes, they're kind of sweet as well, and they can go with sugar.
We want to see how they can think on their feet. And it seems to me that they're all doing a fantastic job of coming up with a way of integrating their mystery ingredient. I think it's fantastic.
I'm confident about my XNO and my custard. I'm not sure about the raspberry and tomato cherries.
Tomatoes actually did help, so I needed that bit of sweetness to, you know, complete my salad. So that's what I'm using, my sun-dried tomatoes.
Guys, you've got 5 more minutes left. You should be starting to plate up your dish by now. We're looking forward to tasting those tomatoes and how it integrates into your dish.
5 minutes to go, and I realize maybe I needed a little bit more time for it to set. I'm holding my thumbs.
Okay. Oh no, wait.
My cheesecake is just a tad too soft. It starts wobbling.
Please, baby. Oh, look. It's okay.
Contestants, 2 minutes remaining. 2 minutes.
I took that pasta out of the water, and there was so much water on the pasta that I was then holding a cup of boiling water in my hand, and I didn't care. I don't care.
60 seconds, guys. Only 60 seconds remain.
Please, baby.
30 seconds to go, guys. Get the food on the plate. Finish it off now. In 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. That's it. Stop cooking. Done enough. Well done.